Coming at you fast. It is January something out now. It's like the second week of January, and it's 61 degrees outside. I'm wearing my normal gloves because it's so nice out. But yeah, I'm glad I'm back. I'm sorry I've been kind of late in my videos. We've kind of run out of content because not much has been going on, and on top of that, it's been so fucking piss-freezingly cold. That we can't. It's just even the SI wasn't even running. It's just like, oh, what am I to do? Do a vlog in the Focus? Focus SE piece of shit? No, hell no.
You should know the Ford Focus SE comes with a standard rear view camera.
Ugh. But yeah. But either way, that's enough bitching about the weather because it's nice out. Ha! And there is something interesting going on. So a few months back, I made a thing about the hype of the Wii U, right? And I really wanted to talk about that. So Nintendo, last week, last week, the week before, they decided to finally have the reveal for the Switch. And it started at 11 o'clock, so I'm sitting there. It's gaming night, Thursday gaming night, and me and my friends huddled together on the couch. We stopped all gaming. We got our other buddies who are online. They're all sitting there. We're watching it. We're ready to go. And it starts. And we're like, holy shit. Holy shit. This is it. This is it. Yeah, Nintendo's going to finally fucking realize their mistakes and come back. And, yeah. About those mistakes.
What's wrong with you?
So, the price of the Switch, I was assuming $300. $250 to $300. I'm glad it wasn't over that. It is $300, but it doesn't come with any games at all. No games. Not a single fucking game. The games, which they didn't talk about at the conference or the reveal, are gonna be $60 each for a handheld. Nintendo also downplayed the handheld. And then they came out and said, oh, battery life's going to be anywhere between 2.5 and 6 hours. So you can guarantee that 2.5 hours is going to probably be the majority of what you get, with the screen setting probably turned down to low. And yeah, you know, good luck. Good luck. That's going to be like airplane mode on, no Wi-Fi, screen turned all the way down to low. You know, can't even see when you even squint in a dark room. That's what I'm coming to expect right now from Nintendo, from this console for battery life. But, you know, in retrospect, the original DS, which I did own one, but not when it came out. I bought one for nostalgia's sake, just to see how bad it was. But the original DS had about 2 to 4 hours, I think, of battery life. So I guess in retrospect, it isn't horrible, but then they started revealing the games. And that's kind of where things went south for the winter. Because, well, what games? What fucking games? The first thing they revealed was the HD vibration feature of the Joy-Con controllers, and that they're motion controlled. You jingle them and you get ice cubes. And I'm just sitting there going, are you fucking kidding me? Like, seriously? You jingle glass drink. Okay, great. Okay, I get it. You're using haptic feedback, or probably a really cheap Chinese knockoff of haptic feedback. But it's not, like, anywhere near the level of probably detail that we want from real things. Gotta be first, Ohioans, don't you? And then you're gonna ride the line. It's just shit like that. Bye-bye. Sorry. Can't stand people who do that shit. I don't know. It was just really disappointing from that aspect. Okay, we're going to demo some more features that no one's going to really care about, and probably barely any are going to use. And then the other shit started coming out from Nintendo. And when I say shit, I mean, oh god, what the fuck am I looking at?
What's wrong with you?
And that was, the first trailer for their game called
Pikachu Switch.
It starts off with what looks like, you know, a Western-style shootout. And the two guys have their hands on their holsters. They're thinking, oh, this is going to be like Dead and Buried. Sweet. You know, it's going to be a Dead and Buried-like game. But honestly, I mean, you kind of have a lot to live up to now that the touch is out. And that's pretty fucking amazing. So, you know, they shoot, and next thing you know, they're holding that, which you expect. They're holding the Joy-Con controllers. And then it shows a time. And I'm sitting there thinking to myself, well, that's strange, okay. And then they showed some other things. And I'm like, what the hell's going on? What the fuck is this shit? And Kieran was just like, nope, I'm done, and just peaced the fuck out and went back into the computer room and started playing Vermintide. And like, what the fuck is this shit? Like, it was like watching a slow motion train wreck. You didn't want to watch it, but you couldn't turn away. It's like looking at Nightmare Fuel or something, like on a fucking porn gallery or something. You know, you, oh my god, it's terrible, but you can't fucking look away. You just can't. And they start talking about, it's like, oh, when you play 1-2 Switch, you don't look at the screen. You look at the person's eyes while you play it. Fuck that! I don't want to play that shit! And I thought for this whole conference, this whole reveal, that was packaged with it. I'm like, where the fuck is Wii Sports? Where the fuck is Weaver, or the Wiiverse that we had in the Wii U? Nothing. Turns out, that game? $60 or $50, you have to buy it. Yeah. Fuck that. That was their first reveal. And then they had another game with a Japanese schoolgirl with a very short skirt and another guy who looked like a guy who gets pissed off at the office way too much, and her ribbons start going down her arms, and me and Tom are like, oh shit, it's tentacle porn, they did it, they fucking did it, oh god, no. And it turned into like springy arms of boxing gloves, and we're like, what the fuck? And then the guy does the same thing, we're like, what the fuck is going on here? What is this shit? What the fuck is this shit? And then they start showing it, and then they demo the game, and they're talking like, oh, it's a fighting game where you punch with your hands, turn it into that. And we're like, what the fuck is that? Okay. And then Todd's like, oh, these are going to be our new mascots. Are you kidding me? Generic A girl and generic B boy? Really? Going to be your new mascots, right? Yeah. Yeah, sure, Nintendo. Uh-huh. Yeah, no, it's definitely not something, that interested me, and I was like, really, like, oh god, please. Okay, where's Smash Brothers? Okay, Smash Brothers is gonna come up next. And then they showed some other games. And then they came out and said, oh, by the way, we're gonna have, this is gonna be completely region free. And we're like, oh, thank god, about fucking time you did that. But then, before they released another game, they came out and said, by the way, Nintendo's online service is going to be paid for, and it's going to have benefits. The benefit is that you get a rental fucking copy of a ROM of their NES or SNES once a month, and then after the month is done, because you wouldn't be playing that game anymore, they yank it back. You can choose to buy it, by the way, but that's it. This is compared to Xbox Live giving you massive discounts, or even more so, giving you free fucking retail games that are not that old. And Nintendo's like, we're going to give you a ROM you can go right now and download for free, pretty much, any fucking website. And we're going to give that to you for a month. At this point in the show, I was kind of like, are you fucking kidding me? Like, this has got to be a joke. Like, this is a big joke. They can't have their heads so far up their ass that they don't have any idea. Like, there's no way. They have their heads so far up their fucking ass. There's no way. This is a joke. This is all a big fucking joke. But tomorrow, when this is all over with, it's just gonna be a joke. Right from there, boom, to the next segment of the video, or the reveal, and they're talking about another game. A few Japanese sprinkles here and there: Xenoblade Chronicles 2, the Fire Emblem. And they were just snippets, just like really quick snippets. They weren't like full-on trailers. They weren't anything like that. They were just quick 1-2 duns. And then they brought in the third parties. First in the line, of course, was Todd Howard of Bethesda. Cool. You've lost a lot of my respect, Bethesda, because, you know, ZeniMax and their whole bullshit argument against, you know, they want $2 billion from fucking Facebook. But that's another video I'll talk about another time. Lo and fucking behold, they're like, oh yeah, Skyrim's coming for the Wii, or the Wii U, the Nintendo Switch. No idea when. But hey guys, it's coming out. Just you wait. And I'm sitting there going, really? That's it, right? Turns out that game is going to be $60. Who wants to buy a 7-year-old game for $60? I don't. I'm pretty sure you don't either. Game's 7 years old. Then EA came on. They didn't even show a game. They just said, FIFA is coming to the Switch. You know, FIFA that you can get on every platform, including mobile. Because, yeah, that's it. No other things. No Crytek shit. Nothing. Just, oh, FIFA's going to come, and that's it. And then they were off. They peaced in and peaced the fuck out like that. So I'm like, okay, what's next? What else do we got? What else can we conjure up from this ball of bullshit? And they bring on a few other people. They talk about Sonic Mania. I think they talked about Sonic Mania. I can't remember. I got Sonic Mania on the mind right now because that's coming out soon. So it's coming out in spring. But it's just, there's such a lack of anything and effort. Nothing. So then after that was done, we went on to the next segment, which was a complete bullshit thing. About how to play with Joy-Con and stuff. And it's utilizing, you know, family, and they have the controllers, and they talk about what's included, which is nice. You know, that's nice they did that. They didn't tell us how much this shit was going to cost until the next day. So, let's go over the cost of this stuff. If you want another dock, you're looking at $90. Yep, $90 for a piece of plastic with a USB-C port that converts to friggin' HDMI. That's it. That's it, $90, just for a fucking thing I could 3D print and make within 10 minutes. With an Arduino board. And not even a fucking breadboard, I just fucking sour that shit. That's it, that's all they have, $90 for that. The Joy-Con controllers, two of them cost $80. $80. Oh, and one more thing I forgot to mention too about the Joy-Cons is the Joy-Cons have a leap motion in them. And if you don't know what the leap motion is, it's like a tracker so you can track your hands. Well, the left one you can point at your right hand, do, you know, rock, paper, scissors. Or, I'm sorry, rock, paper, scissors, and that's it. And I'm sitting there going, are you, okay, more gimmicks, good job, great. Something I didn't care about, don't care about, don't want to fucking care about. Let's get the gimmicks in there more. Let's gimmick this thing up. Let's see how many gimmicks we can throw in one shoot. And the whole time Nintendo was talking about, like, this was a culmination of all their consoles combined. To me, at the end of the reveal, it kind of felt like it's their Wii U that they're trying to push again. And I wasn't too thrilled about it. Any excitement I had for this device is gone. In fact, we didn't even pre-order it. Our friend Sky wanted to get one, and since he's moving in, we were like, well, fuck it, you know, we'll just pre-order it for you. So we went there on Monday to pre-order the Switch, and Nintendo said that they're not going to have any shortages of this fucker. Get to GameStop, all the pre-orders are gone in the entire United States and across the world. So GameStop, EB Games, Funko Land, or whatever they call it over there, in other areas, Babbage's, I guess. All those games gone. Are all those systems completely sold out? Walmart completely sold out. Target completely sold out. Best Buy completely sold out. Amazon completely fucking sold out. And I'm sitting there going, great. Now what? So we can't order it for Sky. But there's not going to be a shortage. No, no, no. And then a few days later, Reggie's like, oh yeah, there's not going to be a shortage. No, no, it's going to be fine. We're going to have 2 million units. 2 million units. If I remember correctly, in Japan, don't they buy like 500,000 of these fucking things anyway? So, there's half a million gone overnight, and then it leaves the entire rest of the world, which is Europe, is a big supplier or big buyer of the Nintendo products as much as the United States, I think. So okay. So is Nintendo going to artificially shortage these things like they did with the Wii U? Let me see, the NES Classic. Yep, they're going to fucking do that too. So Nintendo didn't learn shit at all. Not a single goddamn fucking thing. They didn't learn goddamn shit from their past mistakes. And there was no reveal of Smash Brothers. They did reveal Mario 8, Mario Kart 8 Deluxe, which is an upgraded version. But they didn't say, like I mentioned in my last video, if you can upgrade it for free. So you might have to rebuy the whole fucking game over again. You know, like fucking buying a Capcom Street Fighter game. It's like, oh yeah, we added all these new characters and levels to the exact same game, and we named it called Hyper Super Bullshit Game. And, oh yeah, you have to buy $60 again to actually get these characters. You can't DLC them. And then we're going to lock 90% of the characters in DLC, so you have to buy those too. It just kind of felt like that. It's like, what the fuck are Japanese gaming companies thinking? What are they absolutely thinking? It makes no sense. It's like, what are you fucking doing? Are you stupid?
What's wrong with you?
Are you that fucking thick?
What's wrong with you?
It's just like, I've never been more disappointed from Nintendo in my life. And that's saying a lot with the fucking Wii U's release back in 2012. And that thing was all disappointment and nothing else. But I have never been more disappointed than I am right now with Nintendo. They fucking botched this thing horribly. No Smash Brothers. We're probably going to have to rebuy Mario Kart. And, oh yeah, they revealed Super Mario Odyssey, okay? Where basically it's a video game version of the Super Mario Brothers movie at this point. It looks awesome, I'm not gonna lie, but they did Sonic Adventure it, and I actually am interested in playing this game. A lot, actually. I don't even want to do a review on it. But they came out and said, oh, this is not coming out until next fucking Christmas. So we're sitting there just wondering, okay, so that's great. No Smash, no anything else, no idea what the Virtual Console is going to bring us. And we're just wondering, what's next? Like, what the fuck is next? Is this guy going to want the anime? So we're just, you know, we're sitting there and like going, okay, great. So is that it? Is that everything? Is that everything that we were hoping for? Where the fuck's Zelda? And then they end the conference and say, thank you so much for coming and joining us today. Blah, 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 blah. Oh, wait. Before they did that, they introduced Splatoon 2. No HD remake of Splatoon, but Splatoon 2. It is coming sometime in the spring, but honestly, I don't give a shit. I don't really care for Splatoon. I did actually finally play it, and I was like, eh, it's okay. So, it's not a game that would sell me that Wii. Or the Wii. I keep calling it the fucking Wii. The Switch. It's because it's like the fucking Wii U. So, I am cursing a lot. I'm sorry. Well, you know, no, I'm not fucking sorry, but I'm pissed. I'm so pissed with Nintendo. They really screwed up again. But they proved to us that they learned absolutely nothing from their past mistakes. They don't care about their fans. They care about basically just trying to scrape by and do things. And the third-party developer support was just completely anemic. But Splatoon happened. They had this really... really weird guy kind of show up.
Here you see the latest piece of technology. This weapon set is called the Splat Dualies. Not only do these dual-wielded weapons let you shoot ink from each hand, they also have nozzles that can propel you at a high rate of speed to outmaneuver your opponents. It is a fearsome weapon in the hands of...
And he's just like acting like it's a real thing. And we're just sitting there going, what the fuck is wrong with this guy? And I understand he's into his game, but I mean, we're like looking at him like, what is he doing? And then he's got like these paintball gun 3D printed things for the Splatoon, and he's just like talking about it like it's a real fucking thing. Seriously? Are you serious? You just fucking threw your cigarette and you didn't even put it down on the ground. You put it right out the window. What a fucking asshole. I'm paying attention. But yeah, so... anyway, he's going absolutely hog wild talking about this shit like it's real. And I'm just sitting there going, dude, stop, please. This is killing me slowly. This is like someone forcing me to watch Teletubbies with them so we can make a riff track of it. Like, even then, and I'm making a riff track of it, I still want to slip my fucking wrist slowly. Long ways. Or I should say, the right way. Left and right for attention, up and down for results. But, and at the end he dabs or something. I'm just like, stop! I am the one, the way your time, no- Okay, good, it's done. Completely blah. I don't remember the order exactly of all the games, but 1-2 Switch was the first one, and it kind of just was like, fuck this. So then after that was done, then they're like, oh, thank you so much for coming to Nintendo, blah, 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 have a good night, everyone, leave. And we're like, what the fuck? What the fuck is this shit? What? No Zelda? Nothing? And all of a sudden, the music starts playing for Zelda, and we're like, oh my god, you've been fucking blueballing us all goddamn day, and now you're gonna finally play this shit, you fucking cunt fucks. You son of a bitch. And we're like, really? And they start showing the trailer. It's in Japanese, which is like, okay. And it goes, it's a lot longer. I'm like, oh, wow, this looks great. Awesome. You know, it's done and it ends. And, you know, it's got voice acting in it. I'm like, holy shit. This is great. Release date, March 3rd. We're like, yeah, finally. Finally, something that we're going to have when this thing releases. Hell yeah. But that's it. That's the only game that I'm actually interested in for the Switch, is the Breath of the Wild. And to make things better, we went to go pre-order that too on, you know, Monday, and all we could get is the normal version. Nintendo artificially limited the collector's editions for fucking Breath of the Wild. They sold out, according to GameStop, in 6 minutes on that day when they opened up the pre-orders. Six fucking minutes. What the fuck? Like, are you fucking kidding me? Like, what are you fucking doing, Nintendo?
What's wrong with you?
And the Master Collection Edition, which is $130, sold out in less time, they said. So I was all excited to get the Breath of the Wild Collector's Edition. You know, it's kind of like a late Christmas gift / I guess early birthday gift for Sky, because that's the game he really wants. And, you know, we'd have the music CD with it, we'd have, you know, a little collector's poster and stuff like that. Nope. So fuck it. When the game comes out, I'm going to pirate the living piss out of that fucking CD. Because fuck you, Nintendo. And then I'm not done with being pissed off at them. So before I end this video, I just wanted to finish up and finalize one more thing. Nintendo did not learn anything in the past. They proved that. When they started releasing the prices the next day for some of these things, they proved they did not, they proved that they don't care. They're trying to make this a portable console, and then they come out and say, oh, this is going to coexist alongside the 3DS. The 3DS is going nowhere. So pretty much, this is another Wii U. And in my previous video where I said I'm super excited about this, guys, you know what? I'm not super excited anymore. I actually think that you should probably wait until next Christmas to get one of these. And then be very careful if you wait till next Christmas, because they still might have a fucking artificial shortage to drive up fucking inflation and cost and bullshit like that. So just be really careful, because you know what? Nintendo is doing it again, and they're doing Nintendo again. They're just doing a Nintendo. It's a fucking verb and noun now. It's not just a noun. They're doing or pulling a Nintendo. So yeah, Sky wants to get one, so he's gonna get one. I am completely disinterested in it. Kieran is completely disinterested in it. Andy's completely disinterested in it. All of our friends are disinterested in it. And there's no fucking games coming out. Like, there's literally no fucking games. So what's the fucking point? Good job, Nintendo. Also, Angry Joe, who was talking about the reveal, started his video off of a rant because fucking Nintendo did a Nintendo and DMCA'd all his goddamn videos, even though it's of a live stream that should not have any fucking property bullshit yada yada to it. And they DMCA'd all his shit, and he finally was able to get a video up, he turned the screen of the live stream, like cockeyed, shortened it down, put some other stuff on it, so that he could actually just show it off. It is total bullshit. And yeah, and all the whole things about Nintendo allowing people to stream their stuff and let's play their stuff. Nope, they're still doing it. Nintendo, it's not Nintendo of America that's doing this. Joe did clarify, it's Nintendo of fucking Japan. So fuck you, Nintendo of Japan. I am probably, and at least for me, I'm never gonna buy another console you have again, even if it's got Pokemon on it. And that's another thing. It's been a few days since the reveal, and Nintendo and Game Freak have said nothing about an actual tried to tested and true real Pokemon game coming out for the Switch. There's a Pokemon mini game thing, you know, like we've seen on the fucking Wii and shit, but there is no official real Pokemon game yet coming for this thing. So that's kind of scary. But yeah, like the other people like out there, Jim Sterling and them, and Angry Joe, fuck you, Nintendo. Fuck you. This is the Flying Brick. Hey guys, thank you for watching. I want to thank my subscribers so very much for tuning in. If you like what you see, subscribe to the channel. We post every Tuesday and Thursday.
You butthole! Look what he's doing right now!